Amish Tripathi is one of the most celebrated Indian author known for his captivating storytelling through mythology and fiction. His journey as an author began with the immensely popular Shiva trilogy. His ability to blend ancient Indian mythology with a modern narrative explores universal themes such as love, duty, and destiny, which transcend generational boundaries. Amish's work often explores philosophical and moral themes, offering readers a fresh perspective on age-old legends. Beyond his literary contributions, he is recognized for his thought-provoking talks and engagements on various platforms. With each new release, Amish continues to leave an incredible mark on the literary landscape. Amish is here today with Team Praja Vahini to share his insights into the latest work, Idols.
Wonderful, wonderful being here. You saw a big crowd to sign the books, and it was a pleasure being with my sister Bhavna Didi on stage. So Bhavna Didi and I, my elder sister and I, we've written Idols, and the entire idea is to explain the concept of Murti Puja and why we are such proud Murti Pujaks. Dee, if you want to add anything.
There are so many inspirations. I would say the main inspiration is our Devis and the Devatas and what they have done for our lives, in our lives. And we want to share this treasure with all of us.
Wonderful. And whenever you are touching a mythological subject, every character you have put through, be it Sati, be it Sita, all the Murtis or all the Devis that you have bought in life, along with, of course, your Shiva trilogy, which I have always been a fan of. What is the kind of emotional research that you go through? Because historically things are available for you, and you, of course, you delve into your own journey.
One is, of course, research through reading, and you know, our family background. Our family was such that we learned a lot of our traditions. But you're absolutely right, because a story is driven by emotions, and emotions you don't research, you just feel it. We feel a lot of emotions, a lot of very deep emotions for our culture, for our Devis, for our Devtas. We are very, very proud Indians, and that informs the story that we write, since we feel so deeply for it.
And how much does the belief system allow your creative liberties to go beyond and stay to the facts again?
You know, creative liberties is a very Western term. Because it sounds like I am so brilliant that I can take liberties with the gods, which is not the way our traditions were. So if you read Bhasa, you know, the great Sanskrit playwright, or Kalidasa, they would never use the Sanskrit equivalent of creative liberties. They would use the Sanskrit equivalent of a respectful interpretation in the honor of our gods and goddesses. That's the way I write. If you write that way, then even if you write a different interpretations, it's automatically respectful. And I think readers can sense that as well.
And being an Indian, we have in some form, we have always been taught to have idol or murti puja. So how are you reiterating that through your book?
In fact, actually, that's what this book is about. I'll take a copy of Idols, and this is actually what the book is about. If you see at the, there is actually a murti at the beginning, and the title is Unearthing the Power of Murti Puja. And what Didi and I realize, that many of the youth today, kids today, who will probably do Murti Puja simply because their parents are telling them to do it. It's not because they believe in it. So when they grow up, will they continue? God knows, right? And we are trying to explain through this book, what are the philosophical underpinnings, what's the foundation of the practice of Murti Puja, what makes idol worshippers intuitively more liberal, intuitively more respectful of the environment, intuitively more respectful of women's rights, of LGBT rights. Idol worshipping kind of naturally does that without you even realizing it. We're trying to explain those philosophies through this.
Well, it's not just about an idol, but how that
impacts how you think. Because the fundamental philosophy at the heart of idol worshipping is that we see the divine in everything. That's a very respectful, liberal way of seeing life.
Anadi? What's the concept of bringing your sister into the picture? Like, is there any specific idea that both of you have to write this together?
She's in our family, everyone reads a lot. But she is the intellectual in the family. She reads more than all of us. She and Dad used to read the most. So any philosophical discussion used to happen with her. There's no better person to write the book with. A book on philosophy. Dharma, the prequel to this, was also written with Bhavna Didi. So this is the second book, second project between Didi and me. Didi, if you want to add something.
You talked about creative liberties, and Amish talked about respectful expressions. Sudha Murthy ji is here. She had once said, Shraddhai Danam, Ashraddhai Nadanam. I would extend that further and say, Shraddhai, do everything. Ashraddhai, don't do everything. And this is taught to us by, once again, our Devis and Devatas.
Again, you're referring to Devis and Devatas, your intelligence and intellect is definitely is shown. But do you think bringing the feminine energy into the knowledge that you're sharing with people, is it going to make a little more?
Certainly. Certainly. In the Indian way, there's never a dominance of the masculine or the feminine. There's no dominance of the one male god or the vengeance of the feminine goddess. It's always about balance between the masculine and the feminine. And I think the ideal relationship which represents that is the wonderful relationship between Lord Shiva and Goddess Parvati. There's so much that we can learn from that.
Do you want to add something to that?
In the creative space, my feminine finds an absolute fit with the masculine in my brother.
That's amazing. Wonderful. Thank you
Thank
so
you.
Much.
Thank you. Thank you.